Come to me, Novena. Daily Prayer 1. Lord Jesus Christ, by your patience in suffering, you hallowed earthly pain and gave us the example of obedience to your Father's will. Be near me in my time of weakness and pain. Sustain me by your grace, that my strength and courage may not fail. Heal me according to your will, and help me always to believe that what happens to me here is of little account if you hold me in eternal life, my Lord and my God. Amen. Daily Prayer 2. Lord, look upon me with eyes of mercy. May your healing hand rest upon me. May your life-giving powers flow into every cell of my body and into the depths of my soul, cleansing, purifying, restoring me to wholeness and strengthen for service in your kingdom. Amen. Daily Prayer 3. Lord, please heal my broken heart. Fill me with the peace and joy I know can only come from you during this hard time. Walk closely beside me during my journey to healing and recovery that I know is possible through your power alone. In Jesus' name, amen. Come to me, Novena, Day 11. Day 11, Reflection. Lord, I sense your life-giving water is flowing so freely for all today. I see it sparkling in your light with beauty as it flows from your throne. I can hear the sounds of freedom splashing against the banks. It is calling one and all to come and drink and be filled with this rich and powerful life-giving source. The call is going out to the stranger who has never seen or tasted of your true and living waters, those whose God is religion and not salvation through the grace of Jesus Christ, those who wander through this life and exist on mere fables and theories. The call is to the prodigal who once tasted and thrived, but then decided his own path, who has forfeited the treasures of joy and peace that only your waters can bring because of a seemingly better way. The call is to the stubborn who thinks they have no need of you, those who think you don't exist and insist on denying you. They accept the counterfeit water offered by the worldly system. The call is to the churchgoers who stand in the congregation weekly, offering up praise from a heart that doesn't know you personally. The call is to the man or woman who stands behind the pulpit, who has no real connection to your Holy Spirit, who just reads the words from their notes and tries to make them pertinent, to those who are dying from the rhetoric. The call is to the husband or wife who has lost their love for their family because of lust and desire to be with someone that belongs to another. The call is to the youth today, those who are searching for love and acceptance, those who are desiring family and a home where love and truth prevails. The call is to the addicted, those who have sold their very soul to this trap and they can't get out. Freedom is available through the precious blood of Jesus. This call is to the congregation of people who attend services of programs and rituals that have replaced the Word of God being preached in the spirit of truth and power of your resurrection. This call is to those who have lost their passion for you, Lord, those who no longer desire to be in your presence and feast at your table. This call is to the deceiver and the one who is striving so hard to convince someone else that good is evil and evil is good. Lord, I pray that those who have ears to hear will hear, and not only hear the call, but heed the call. Many souls are thirsty in a dry and desert land, but there is a river that flows from your throne to fill all who will come and drink of your water. Only Jesus can give this gift that every soul desires, living water. And the Lord speaks. Listen to me, my precious child. I created you and have cared for you since before you were born. I will be your God throughout your lifetime until your hair is white with age. I made you, and I will care for you. I will carry you along and save you. I will carry you in my arms, holding you close to my heart. For I know the plans that I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Since I care so much for you, don't worry about getting your needs met, and don't worry about tomorrow. Scripture reference, Matthew chapter 6, verse 25 to 34. Just as I look after the little sparrow, so will I look after you. Scripture reference, Matthew chapter 10, verse 26 to 31. So give your burdens to me, and let me give you rest. Scripture reference, Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. Talk to me when you're anxious, and let me put you at peace. Scripture reference, Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. No matter what happens, your soul will be safe in my hands. Scripture reference, John chapter 10, verse 28. Like a mother bird, I'll cover you with my feathers in my nest. Scripture reference, Psalms chapter 91, verse 1 to 4. When the rivers of difficulty roar, you will not be swept away. When fiery trials blaze, you will not be burned. Scripture reference, Isaiah chapter 43, verse 2. When war breaks out, I will be your fortress and ever-present help in trouble. Scripture reference, Psalms chapter 46. Even when you face death, I will take you by the hand and lead you on the joyful path to eternal life. Scripture reference, Psalms chapter 16, verse 9 to 11. So don't be afraid when you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, because I am your good shepherd, and I will be with you, comforting you and protecting you on your journey. Scripture reference, Psalms chapter 23. And I will never leave you. Scripture reference, Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5. Day 11 prayer. Wash me clean, Lord, and help me to see my motives in all I say and do. May my thoughts and actions come from you and not from any legalism or idea that I may have gathered along the way. Sometimes our concept of how to get your attention may not be what you want to hear at all. It is not necessarily the one that sings the best or has the best testimony of deliverance. Those things can make us feel good in our own eyes, but distract us from what you're really looking for in us. Men watch us and judge us by what they see and hear, but you, Lord, you judge our motives. Lord, it is not always in our accomplishments that we get your attention, but in our weakness, in our deficiencies. It is in that time of facing a defeat that we cry out for your mercy, and standing all alone, we become very real with you. We need you to be very firm with us, because our days are running out, and we are coming to the day when we will stand before you, the righteous judge, and hear you call our name. Our deeds will be judged righteous or wicked. I want to be clean and acceptable in your eyes, Lord, because we cannot hide under a cloak of pretense. It will not matter what we or anyone thinks of us, but what you know about us. I want to be real with you, Lord. Never fake or phony, but genuine and pure. Amen. Pray the Our Father prayer 7 times. Holy Spirit, for every ray of sunshine I see today, heal me of my coldness and darkness of heart. Fill me with your warmth and your light. Amen.